If you open the Surface Settings dialog and click on the New button, the content of the built-in catalog becomes accessible. A search using the keyword grass will return two types of grass: texture-based grass, which renders fast but the surface remains flat, and 3D grass, whose geometry is not visible while working in the 3D window, but rather only when the scene is rendered. Rendering this requires a considerable amount of processing power. As rendering a 3D grass is an extremely time-consuming process, it's important to be aware of a few things before you overwhelm your landscape with it. Computers with mechanical hard drives will render the 3D grass much slower. Therefore, an SSD instead of a hard drive is highly recommended. In addition, 3D grass requires a significant amount of memory, especially when covering a huge area with it. Consider 16 gigabytes of RAM as a minimum in cases of smaller surfaces. When a large area is covered with 3D grass, even 16 gigabytes of memory will be insufficient, and CineRender will start to use the hard drive intensively and occupy a lot of space during the render. In order to keep the render time low, try to follow these recommendations. Use 3D grass on smaller areas only. When you cover an area that's far from the camera with 3D grass, keep the density of the grass low. In general, try to keep the density low regardless of the distance from the camera. The 3D grass consists of two major parts: the base material, defined mainly by the color as well as other channels, and the body of the 3D grass, which is defined by the grass channel. These two are independent and can be adjusted as necessary. For example, when turning off the grass channel, we can see in the rendered image that in the color channel a bitmap image of the grass is in use. When turning back to the grass channel, the 3D body of the grass is rendered as well. These two major components help each other when creating a surface covered with grass. The following renders are a great example of how important it is to have a bitmap image of grass surface in the color channel as the base. Here we have a bitmap image of soil in the color channel, and the grass channel is turned off. Now the grass channel is on. Surprisingly, the density of the grass is the same as it is in the render on the right side of the screen, yet the perceived visual difference is huge. The only difference between these two renders is the base of the grass. When rendering grass, please make sure to have the grass option turned on in the Render Settings dialog.